What is it like just frustrating other teams the way that you have over the last few weeks?
I think it's very funny seeing people like struggle and get mad at their own teammates for something that they didn't really do. It's more like my fault. It's not really that funny, but I think it's funny.
Nadia Cooper left all the way to being named both the Pac-12 Goalie of the Year and Freshman of the Year today. Cooper took over for the Cougs in goal 5 games into the season and never left. She's only allowed 8 goals this year, which is the 3rd best mark in the NCAA. It's been a season for Nadia filled with wins, but it also brought the most significant loss of her life.
I hate attention. I literally hate when people are always like, good job, Nadia. I don't know what to do with it, so I kind of just give them a thumbs up and call it a day.
Nadia Cooper may have to get used to that attention as she has become one of the best goalies in the country this year as a freshman. She says her teammates have helped her adjust to her new normal.
They also helped me calm down and realize that I earned this spot and I earned everything I worked for, so just own it.
Nadia's squad has helped her on the field, but their biggest contribution has easily been off of it.
My team doesn't let me bundle in all the feelings ever since I told them. They kind of like would ask me questions, make me talk. They wouldn't let me stay quiet.
September of 2021 was supposed to be an exciting time for Nadia. She was beginning her freshman year at WSU and had her first start for the Cougs on September 12th. However, it also began one of the most difficult experiences of her life.
It's just really hard to like think that it happens to other families, not mine.
Nadia's mom, Caroline, contracted COVID-19 and pneumonia in September and was put into the hospital. She beat both illnesses, but her lungs were ravaged and things began to deteriorate once again. She suffered multiple heart attacks and eventually had to be placed in a medically induced coma.
Me and my dad just were texting at the time when she flatlined again, had another heart attack, and he was just telling us that she just needs to go. It's like hurting her more than it's hurting us right now. So it's kind of just him just telling her that it's her time. She fought hard and that it's just easier for everyone if it just stopped.
Thankfully, Nadia was able to fly home and talk to her mom, even if Caroline was unconscious right before that conversation Nadia had with her father.
The second I flew back, she kind of like gave up. But the way I like to think about it is she was waiting to hear my voice and then she wanted to let go.
Nadia's mom passed away on October 12th. Due to her condition, she never really got to watch her daughter succeed at the collegiate level.
What do you think your mom would say if she knew that you were having all this success right now?
She probably wouldn't have any words. She'd probably be crying like I am. Just give me a hug, pretty much a hug and a kiss.
Nadia says she still feels her mother's presence from time to time, and that she definitely has felt it out on the field.
My little sister's godmother got us all bracelets. I usually wear it during games. I don't know you're not supposed to, but I wear it like under my gloves. There's some games where I haven't worn it, and I just did not play good. So I just feel like superstition, like I have to wear it now.
Nadia, understandably, is still wearing the loss of her mother, but Nadia plans on honoring that loss with wins, which would not only benefit herself, but also the 5 other daughters and husband Caroline left behind.
If you could say something to your mom right now, what would you say?
Mama, I made it. And I'm gonna make it for the whole family and for you.
I couldn't look at you guys while that was going on, or else I was gonna start getting emotional.
Yeah, my goodness,
wow. An incredible story. I'm so grateful for Nadia for sharing that with me. Yeah. And man, RIP to Caroline, and it's incredible.
I mean,
what Nadia's done this year.
18 years old, 19 years old, to have to deal with something so heavy, so young in life. I mean, the poise that she has, it's amazing, right?
It's amazing. You know, she walked into that interview and she was like, I'm not good at talking.
Yeah.
And Wow. I don't think she's not good at talking. It's pretty incredible.
It makes me think of a couple of things. Like, number one, how strong she is. Mm-hmm. Number two, like, how easy my life has been comparatively, right? I mean, Wow, the things she's been through.
It's insane. Here's something that's super crazy. The week of Nadia's mom's funeral, she played in a game on Thursday, then immediately got on a plane, traveled back to Houston for her mom's funeral service, then got on a plane again and started WSU's game on Sunday. It's just super, super crazy, the strength that she has shown. Yeah. I think a lot of us would not have been able to do it.
Okay. It's an incredible story and well told, Brenna. Yeah.
Thank you so much. By the way, WSU Women's Soccer, they play in the first round of the NCAA tournament tomorrow at 5:00 in Pullman. So if you want to take them in, that's probably the last time that we're going to be able to see them in person. And we will be down there for that game.
We're pulling for the Cougs and for Nadia, especially, for right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Be right back after a quick break.